Hey guys, it's Ryan from My Lyme Boots, and I'm at Skin Renewal today, part of the Renewal Institute, to speak to Dr. Leston Lawn about skincare, and in particular acne. I think you're going to stay tuned for this one. So Dr. Leston, tell us, what is acne, blemishes, and breakouts?
Acne happens when there's a blockage of the follicle in the skin. So the skin produces sebum as a natural moisturizer, which travels up the hair usually. But if there's a blockage, then you get congestion or collection of the sebum. The sebum gets trapped, there's then a collection of dead skin cells, and because of the pooling of the sebum, bacteria starts to collect there, which results in a pimple.
And that's when we get that infection.
Yes, and then so the sebum then is stuck there. This oxidizes and causes a blackhead. If that's left there, it causes the inflammatory process just continues and continues. That blackhead can turn into a whitehead, can turn into a yellowhead later, and that's what basically causes a pimple. Because of the inflammation, we get a blemish. Chronic inflammation in the skin leads to pigmentation, and also because of the collection of this basically pus then underneath the skin, if you get a pustule, one can get scarring.
And tell me, why do some people seem to suffer more from acne than others?
There could be various reasons for this. It could be because of stress, it could be because of their diet, it could be because of a hormonal imbalance. Our urban lifestyle now leads to a lot more adult acne than what we used to get. Yeah. So there are various reasons, contributing factors for why some suffer more than others.
What are then the latest treatments and procedures to deal with these problems?
At Skin Renewal, we always have a holistic view when we treat patients. I think that treating acne holistically is one of the newest things. So the fact that one needs to actually look at inflammation in the gut and treat that, because that would resolve inflammation on the skin as well. Then there's certain supplementation that one can take that suppresses the androgenic hormones or the male hormones that cause the acne, specifically dihydrotestosterone.
So do male hormones cause acne?
Yes.
Sure. Okay.
So dihydrotestosterone occurs in both males and females, and an excess of dihydrotestosterone then leads to the acne form. So with supplementation, one can suppress this dihydrotestosterone, and one can start to heal the inflammation in the gut, which then can lead to actually better skin.
So by treating the gut, would you then resolve the problem, or is it just the first step in the process?
It would be the first step in the process, and it would definitely depend on your lifestyle going forward whether you'd resolve the problem or not. Then there are many treatments that one can do. There's very specific medical skincare ranges that you can use. Then there are chemical peels that one can do. We use specifically salicylic acid or azelaic acid. Okay. And there are various lasers also that one could use to treat acne. The other thing would be to do combination treatments instead of just doing a peel or just doing a laser, but actually combining certain chemical peels and certain lasers in treatment.
So Dr. Leston, the current treatments, how do they differ from the way we treated acne in the past?
Well, in the past, I think that we had less of a holistic approach and we stuck to the basic acids, as I said, salicylic acid and azelaic acid. And we now know that if we combine it with lasers like Limelight A or laser genesis or even carboxytherapy, so there are definitely new therapies that we can use to treat the acne with. And then by treating the gut, you treat the skin. So the skin is often seen as a dashboard. Okay. So if there's inflammation or acne on the skin, or if there's hyperpigmentation on the skin, or whatever there might be on the skin, you know that there's definitely inflammation in the body and that there's something happening underneath that one needs to go and investigate further.
Mm. I like that dashboard analogy. So Dr. Leston, how does acne differ between the different skin types?
I'd say the biggest difference is the fact that because of the chronic inflammation that gets caused by the acne, with darker skin types, their melanocytes react differently, so they tend to form hyperpigmentation easier than the fairer skin types.
And treatments, do the treatments differ?
The treatments definitely differ. There are stronger acids that one could use on lighter skin types than as opposed to the darker skin types. There are certain types of lasers that are only allowed on lighter skin types. Something like Limelight A is, for example, not allowed to be used on a darker skin type because the laser will cause further hyperpigmentation then.
So Dr. Leston, is there a difference in acne between males and females?
Well, yeah, again, I'd say the root cause of the acne is the same. The biggest difference between the treatment of male patients versus female patients would be that with female patients, one could give them contraceptives which are then high in estrogen just to correct the hormonal imbalance, which one obviously cannot do in male patients.
And talking treatments, talk us through the different types of treatments, treatments we would get, say, at a medical spa like Skin Renewal, where we find ourselves today.
I think the big difference between a medical spa like Skin Renewal and a normal spa would be the combination of treatments. So that one knows that you could use stronger strengths of certain acids or certain chemical peels, and that one could combine these peels with, as I said, like laser genesis or Limelight A.
Dr. Liston, you're awakening my mind to so many new ways to treat acne. In my youth, many, many years ago, my treatment for acne was popping down to Pick and Pay and buying an over-the-counter ointment which worked. Is home-based remedies not a thing we should be considering?
Well, one could definitely use skincare at home, but over-the-counter stuff often contains benzoyl peroxide and high doses of that. And as I said, by drying out the skin too much, you can have a rebound effect where the skin then starts to produce excess sebum, which then would worsen the acne.
So Dr. Liston, based on these treatments that we've been speaking about, what results could I expect to see and over what time frame?
At Skin Renewal, we have great results with our acne patients, but the expectant result would really also depend on the patient's ability to change their lifestyle and stick to that change in lifestyle. If one does more treatments simultaneously on one day, one could get a quicker result.
Dr. Liston, do you have any tips for the viewer at home who is suffering with an acne problem at the moment?
I think if there's one thing that I could say is that the natural tendency or reaction of people would be to over-exfoliate or to use really aggressive, strong acids and think that the stronger the acid or the more I exfoliate, the better the result. But as I was saying, drying out the skin too much can have a rebound effect.
And some people seem to not suffer from acne at a younger stage in their life, but when they become older, in the adult stage, they seem to develop acne problems. Why is that, and is the treatment any different at that stage?
Male patients tend to have more acne during their teenage years than female patients, and as we age, this tends to swap over. The reason for that could be also, as I was saying, lifestyle things. And so as we enter the workplace, we are under a lot more stress, and our urban lifestyle changes our diet completely.
So if I find myself in a situation with acne as a young adult, the thing is to come to a place like Skin Renewal, make an appointment, come see a doctor like yourself and take it from there.
Yes, because I do think, as I said, it's important to find the root cause of the acne. There can be various causes for that, and to have a holistic approach so that one can address all of those.
So there you have it from Dr. Liston himself in terms of how to deal with acne and giving you some steps in terms of what you can do to address the problem. I hope you found some really good takeaways from what he's had to say to us today.